did you get into mermaiding? You said you've been doing it since 2015?
2015, yes. Well, it's funny because I actually, back in the States, I used to be into Renaissance festivals. That's what kind of what got me into like dressing up in the first place. I used to play pirates and villager and royal, like royalty and fairies. I used to play all these different characters. And mermaids was always something I always loved, but I never knew that I could like actually be a mermaid until I came here. And I think it was in 2014, 2015, the mermaid industry really started to blossom. People started making more tails. Just the tails became more available for people. One of the first tail makers was called Mer Taylor, and I actually have one of his tails. It's that blue silicone one. He's one of the first tail makers out there, and I think he was even in Mer People. He was the main one that they talk about.
Okay, yeah.
And so I started off with wanting one of his tails, and I got one. And when I was swimming, I realized that there needs to be a lot of training for mermaiding. It's not just putting on a tail and swimming around. And since I was already a dive instructor at that point, I knew how to swim, but not how to swim properly with a monofin. So that's even like how I got started in the mermaiding in the first place. And then like how I became an instructor is because I saw how hard mermaiding was and I was practicing so much. Mm-hmm. I also saw others who weren't in the diving industry or anything like that, like no swimming swimming skills or anything like that, tried mermaiding as well, and they shouldn't have been in the water with a fin that they didn't know how to swim in. So I thought it was so important to have safety along with mermaiding. So I actually found at the time, and there was only one company teaching the mermaid instructor, which was in 2016, and it was called the Mermaid Swimming Association. And so I went and decided to join their instructor course, and so I did a whole week in the Florida Keys, and where they, it was kind of like a mermaid boot camp almost, like teaching us how to properly swim, how to teach the courses, how to free dive. It was a very hard week, kind of like the same with diving, with the IDC.
Right.
It was kind of like IDC for mermaiding. So in 2016, I then became officially a mermaid instructor for the Mermaid Swimming Association, and I've had that for many years. But I think finally, so now we came out with their mermaiding instructor next, and I actually know the girl who came up with them, Maui Mermaid 1-2. Her name is Lila, and she's actually based in Hawaii, and we actually met and started talking through Facebook, because she was also a mermaid. And I kind of told her my concerns that I had about the mermaid industry, like that I think that people should be certified, kind of like with scuba diving. We need to be open water to be able to, you know, be certified to be able to go scuba diving. And I felt, you know, some of these things should be the same for mermaiding. Because even too here, like I had a lot of kids who were just buying tails and just jumping in the water and didn't know how to properly swim in the tails. Like one of my favorite things is like, I had to teach kids that just because you put on a mermaid tail doesn't mean you can breathe underwater. A lot of times the girls would put on the tail and go straight under the water and not come back up because they thought they could breathe underwater. So I had to teach them that we're still mammals as mermaids, and so we still need to come up and breathe. And so I had to teach them proper breathing techniques and things like that, and how to properly swim, all these things, you know, all safety.